vehicle is leaving the station. Please hold on. Please move to the center of the vehicle and away from the doors.
From the great American Southeast, Atlanta, welcome back to the No Eat Geek. Today we have Disney news, and it's not good news, as you probably expected. Before we get started, I could really use your help. This is a brand new channel, and if you wouldn't mind, if you enjoy this content, click subscribe, share my content, let everybody know about the No Eat Geek, and I appreciate your support very, very much. Mickey is very sad. Look at how he's terribly sad. This article comes from Bounding Into Comics, and as I mentioned, it's not good news. The Walt Disney Company continues to struggle in 2020 as the entertainment conglomerate first has reported its first annual financial loss in over 40 years. There are a lot of reasons for this, and the virus obviously is going to play a big part of this, but there are more reasons as well, and I'll get into that. They suffered a loss of over $5 billion U.S. dollars in revenue as a direct result of the ongoing virus. Spoiler. Come on, if you haven't seen that movie by now. As per Market Watch, according to the company's November 12th quarterly report, Disney's fourth quarter losses totaled $710 million, which led the company to suffer its second consecutive red quarter. Prior to 2020, Disney had not reported a quarterly loss since 2001, when the company ceased operation of the internet search portal Go.com. Never went to Go.com on purpose. I might have accidentally clicked it once. And the company had not seen back-to-back quarterly losses since 1996, since the Olympics were here in Atlanta. It's been a long time. Disney also reported an annual grand total of $2.83 billion in losses, which marks the first time the company has marked an annual loss since 1980. The virus has been cited as the main reason for Disney's financial nightmare, with the company also reporting that the ongoing virus cost them $7.4 billion billion in operating income, with most of this drop coming from its theme parks, experiences, and consumer products, which includes Marvel Comics. I can't imagine why Marvel Comics would be in trouble. I mean, look at the new Warriors. I mean, you've got non-binary characters and safe space in there, and yeah, 2020. Are we done with 2020 yet? It has the best character with a backpack since Dora the Explorer. I'm not sure that's not Dora the Explorer. As for its film division, production delays to upcoming Marvel films such as Black Widow and The Eternals and the continued widespread closure of theaters led to Disney pulling in just $1.6 billion, a drop of $1.7 billion from its $3.31 billion cinematic revenue in 2019. Additionally, the company's total revenue also suffered a significant drop, with Disney reporting only $14.71 billion in 2020 compared to $19.1 billion total the same period last year, for a grand total in $5 billion in revenue loss. During Thursday's report, CEO Bob Chapek recognized that, quote, "It's been a year unlike any other in our lifetimes, and certainly in the history of the Walt Disney Company." But he also assured investors that it was not all lost, as, quote, "The real bright spot has been our direct-to-consumer business, which is key to the future of our company." He continues, "And on this anniversary," I don't know why he talks like this. He's an NPR host. "And on the anniversary of the launch of Disney Plus, we're pleased to report that as of the end of the fourth quarter, the service had more than 73 million paid subscribers, far surpassing our expectations in just its first year," said Chapek. He also spoke of continued closures of Disney parks, particularly in California, and he expressed how Disney leadership was, quote, "extremely disappointed that the state of California continues to keep Disneyland closed, despite our proven track record." I can't keep reading in that voice. He's saying that health and safety protocols are all science-based and have the support of labor unions representing 99% of our hourly cast members. He says, "frankly, as we and other civic leaders have stated before, we believe state leadership, California, should look objectively at what we've achieved successfully at our parks all around the world, Orlando, all based on science, as opposed to setting an arbitrary standard that is precluding our cast members from getting back to work while decimating small business in the local community." Boom, Gavin Newsom. He just put the boom on you. Oh, Ray. Ray might have been the true reason. Let's keep going. The article concludes that the year that saw the departure of former Disney CEO Bob Iger, the furlough of 100,000 workers and laying off 28,000 more, near universal condemnation of its tentpole Mulan remake, the abysmal sales for their highly promoted Marvel's Avengers video game. I heard that's terrible. These annual financial results are devastating, but ultimately unsurprising. I have a few takes on this. Yes, the virus is real. Yes, it has impacted many, many, many lives. With California closed, with the exception of one hair salon, it is basically impossible to have these companies thrive, make money, support each other, support the businesses, having people work. It's just not possible. He mentioned science in the article, and Disney Orlando or Walt Disney World is open. I've been there during the virus, but I will say that Disney is not doing, in my opinion, everything that needs to be done to make their company successful at this time. The theme parks are a shell of what they were. Now, Universal Orlando, on the other hand, is booming with business. Things are open. They had to cancel Halloween Horror Nights, but they still opened up two houses during daytime traffic. They have an ability to queue yourself in line with an app so you're not standing in long lines. Walt Disney World seemed to have gone out of their way to inconvenience as many of their customers as possible. And again, I get it. The virus is a bad thing. But take a look at some of the things that they've done. They've closed a lot of restaurants inside of their parks. A lot of food stands are not open. A lot of shops are not open. The Magic Bands using FastPass, that was one of the best things about Disney, was using FastPass, of having an app where you could schedule, like, hey, this time is open. Let's not stand in lines all day, but let's come back when we're supposed to and get in relatively quick. That's gone. Why in the world, during a virus thing that I can't say here on YouTube, why in the world would Disney take the approach that, hey, you know what? We had a system that might help eliminate lines, but instead, we're going to eliminate that system and everybody's going to wait in lines. Social distance, of course, so it takes twice as long to get through them. Listen, I understand times are rough. They've closed all of the shows in the park. Meanwhile, I went to Busch Gardens in the same state of Florida. I saw the dolphin show. I saw the walrus show. They were both great and full of people, socially distanced. Everybody was safe. Listen, it's no secret that the Disney sequel trilogy for Star Wars, what they call the Skywalker saga, was a complete, utter disaster. And if you don't believe me, go to any toy, go to any store that carries Star Wars merchandise, and you tell me how many figures of Rey and Finn are flying off the shelves. It's not because it was so disjointed. There was no master plan. Daisy Ridley herself mentioned that she was going to be a Kenobi, turned out to be a Palpatine at the last second. Spoilers, if anybody cared. I have two young kids that normally at their age, when I was their age, I would have obsessed about Star Wars, but now nobody cares. They don't care. Their friends at school don't care. They tell their friends that their dad has a YouTube channel that sometimes talks about Star Wars. They don't care. The Marvel franchise is gone complete to hell. Yes, the Avengers ended, I guess, controversially on a high note. Some people liked it, some people didn't. But where are they going now? They don't have a plan, and the plan that they do have sounds abysmal. The comics have gone over 2020 woke. It's overkill. The comics are preaching to fans about how terrible one half of the country is. All of the media. You've got Pedro Pascal, who's starring in about the only thing that Disney seemingly has done right in The Mandalorian, basically calling 50% of the country Yahtzees. I can't say the real word on YouTube because censorship is a real thing. That's right, he actually made that comparison and has since been doubling down on it. This is the state that we are in 2020. I understand that times are rough right now, but you know what? The division that's costing Disney money is being spearheaded by the people up front, their actors, and also the writers. If you don't believe me, look at some of the writers of Star Wars The High Republic. Google them on Twitter. I'm not even going to say this one person's name who I'm thinking, because he's a vile individual that spews hate. This is all under Disney. Meanwhile, again, Universal, as I mentioned, is just booming. Lines out of the park at capacity, frequently on the weekends. Disney, not so much. They had an opportunity to potentially save movie theaters and put money into theaters to start this, just getting people out of the house. But what did they do? And they're like everyone else in Hollywood saying, you all are on your own. And they're pushing their films. Again, about the only thing I think that's taking place right now in Disney is The Mandalorian, a TV show. They've got other TV shows announced, but where are they? We've got these fictitious dates that are floating around, and they're not going to hit them. So, got off on a little bit of a rant, but yes, Disney was severely impacted by the virus. We all have been. In some way, shape, or form, we have all been impacted. But what they could be doing is taking the current conditions, like a lot of companies are forced to do in pivoting and making changes and making customer experience in their theme park that is open as wonderful as it can be. It's continuing to push California to stop being California and let people get back to work. And it's about taking control of their entertainment divisions and creating properties that are actually entertaining and not feeling like they're attending a lecture about the differences between good and bad based on their opinions in this year. Is Disney going to go out of business? No, I don't think so. But they could be in big, big trouble unless they start making changes real soon. Anyway, that's all I have to say on this particular episode of the NWG. I thank you so much for sticking around. Again, as I mentioned at the top, do consider subscribing, sharing, commenting, liking. It all helps me battle the evil algorithms of YouTube. I thank you so much, and we'll see you back here again real soon.
This vehicle is leaving the station. Please hold on. Please move to the center of the vehicle and away from the doors.